Hello. Good morning, children. How you all are? I hope you all are fine at your home.
Yes, no, children?
Yes. Myself, Shalini. I'm going to teach the elements. So, children, in our previous classes, we have started a topic called as numbers. So, which topic we have started? Yes, it was numbers. So, what are all we have discussed in this chapter, children? Remember?
Yes,
we have discussed about how to read and write four-digit numbers, then how to write the number names of it, how to write the number names of four-digit numbers, then we have learned about place, value, chart, then little bit introduction about preceding numbers, succeeding number, and the middle number. So children, let us have a recap of this chapter. So firstly, I have given you one definition. Of number, a number is a mathematical object to count, measure, and label. So, mathematical is a number is a mathematical object which is used for counting, measuring, and labeling. Then I have given you one or two uses of the numbers in our day-to-day life. Then we have discussed about the place value, how to read and write four numbers, and how to write their number names. So, children. Exercise 2.1. So children, all are ready to do the exercise now?
Yes.
Open your book, all of you. Open both your reader book as well as your notebook. And on page number 21, you have exercise 2.1. So page number 21, exercise 2.1 is it. Just you have to look after and you have to understand what I am telling. Okay children? You all are ready?
Yes.
So in that, what is the first bit? Read the following numbers. In this, first bit is read the following numbers. Then write the numbers. Then write.
Don't get confused. Most of you will get confused in this.
So this 1500 by 1500 by 1500 by 76. So I hope you all now practice with four digits also. So let me discuss another example. So one more example I take. 8004. So how to write this number? How to write the number name for it and how to read this number? Yes, it's a very easy number. So first place the comma. First place the comma after hundreds place. So ones, tens, hundreds. So hundreds after you place the comma, then you read this number. 8 is in which place? Thousands place. So what is the number? 8004. So when zeros are before, when zero if you add before the numbers, suppose this is my given number 4. This is my given number. Suppose if I add zeros before the 4, then this 4 remains 4 itself. There is no change in the value of 4. I hope you all understood. So you all can see here 4 is at last. Before 4 you have got 2 zeros. Then also
digits, means which digits in which place it is going to
First question you can take, children. So example, first example 307. So how to prepare the case study chart for it? Already they have given you the boxes. So you need to enter the numbers.
So page number 21. All you can see, children. Already they have given the place value chart box. So directly you have to enter numbers in it. So
first place is units, 10, 100, 10,000. You all can see they have given the four places. But the given number is 3. So how to do it, children? How to do it? Yes. 7 is in which place? 7 is in which place? Thousands? No. So 7 is in units place. 0 is in tens place. And 3 in the hundreds place. No thousands value. Put it anyway. Thousands place value they give you. You make it as empty. Let's go. Place it as empty only. So, I mean one more example you can take. One more example. It is 611. So 611. Again they have given the box like this. Again they have given you the four places: units, tens, hundred, thousand. So how to enter the values, children? Yes, you need to start from the unit place. So always start entering the numbers from the unit place. So unit place is 1, tens is 1, again 100 is 6, thousand square is not there. Leave it empty. So next third question, children. They have given you the 5926. Now they have given you the 4-digit number. Then write in the box, children. Place your chart box. So make the columns like this: units, 10, 100, 1000. Then enter the number. Try it, children. How you are going to enter? How you are going to enter? First 5 year, 9 year, 2 year, 6 year. Whether it is correct? Whether it is correct way to enter? No, it is wrong. So you have to start with ones place. You need to start with ones place, then tens place value you should enter, then hundreds place, then come to enter the thousands place. So what is it? Units place value 6, tens place 2, hundreds place 9, thousands place is 5. So it is very simple way. I give you a few more questions, children. You need to solve in your home. Okay, you will do it now? Yes. Fourth question, 9400. Fifth question, 9991. Sixth question, 6000. Seventh question, 7343. So these four you need to practice. Okay, children, you will do now. It is very easy. So you have to make the base value chart for thousands. Means four box or four columns you have to make, and accordingly you have to enter the numbers in the place values. I hope you all understood. Mainly place values, it identifies the places of the digits. Mainly going to identify the places of the digits, and it makes the reading of the numbers easy. So shall we move to the next bit, children? Yes. What is the next bit in the exercise? 2.1. It is write the following numbers in words. So what is the next bit, children? Write the following numbers in words. So it is like similar to the first bit. I hope first bit you all also wrote in words. So it is also similar to that. So in first bit, first you have read and you have wrote in words. But in this bit, directly you have to write the following numbers in words. So what is the third bit? Write the following numbers in words. In the words, in the sense, you have to write the number name for it. So what is the first question, children? It is 3524. So I hope you all can do it, children. Yes. Start writing. What is this number? So it is one 4-digit number. Where to place the comma? After hundreds place. Then you can read. 3000 and what is left children of 524. So next you have to write 500 509 24. So PW PLT E by 20, FOU by 4. Easy, no children? You will do now. So one more question. 8001. Then how to do it, children? In previous bit I have explained. So I hope you all can easily write it. How to read this number? Yes, it is 8001. So write EIGHT8. Give the comma. Here commas are used to reverb. Means commas mainly we are using to make reading of numbers easy. So it is 8009 easy children? Yes, two more I will give you. Just write it down in your notebook. So third and fourth. So third question is 4967. So it is 4967 and next is 8740. So these two you need to copy and you need to write down in your notebook. Okay? You will do now? Yes. So after this, next week we have write the succeeding number of. So what we have children next week? Succeeding number. Any idea children? Any idea about this? Remember about this? Yes. Succeeding numbers are the numbers. How we are going to obtain? When we do plus 1 to the given number, we will get the succeeding number. Succeeding number is nothing but the next number. Succeeding numbers are nothing but the next number. And how we are going to get succeeding numbers here? Yes. They will give you one number. For that number if you do plus 1, you are going to get the succeeding number. So let us see it an example. So next bit it is write the succeeding number of. Write the succeeding number of. So I hope this answer I have explained. Succeeding number is going to use the concept of forward counting. So it uses the concept of forward counting. I hope you all know what do you mean by forward counting. It's like 1, 2, 3, 4, like this reading. We call it as forward counting. Suppose if I start reading like 10, 9, 7, 6 like this, then we call it as a backward counting. So for succeeding, we need the concept of forward counting. Let us see an example. So 6820. So 6820. So what will be the succeeding? Succeeding means next number. Succeeding means next number or after number. So for succeeding, we also call it as next numbers or after numbers. So first they will give you one number and then they will give you one dash. So how to get the succeeding number children? Yes. Just to simply do plus 1 to the given number. So how to get the succeeding number? You have to do plus 1 to the given number. It is a given number. You have to do plus 1 to the which place, sir? Unit space. I hope you all know how to write the numbers for adding. Always you should start writing numbers from 1 space, 10 space, 100 space, then 1000 space. I hope by doing addition and all, you all have learned how to write the number. So that's why you have to add plus 1 in the unit space. Then you do plus these two. So 0 plus 1, it will be 1 children, not 0. Again 2 plus, here the below numbers are not there. 2 remains 2. Again below number is not there. 8 remains 8. Again 6. Below nothing is 6. So what is the succeeding of 6820 children? Yes, it is 6821. Easy, no? So whatever they will give you the number, you have to do plus 1.
you need to do plus 1 for the given number. Like one more example
you can take 4200. How to get the succeeding number of this figure? Simple. For last in this case, do plus 1. So 0 plus 1, 1, 0. Again no number, 2, again 4, as it is. So it is 4200. Easy, no? You all can do it. Okay, I'll give you some more example. Just try me out. Okay? 3948. So next number is 3948. Next question. 3999. Next fifth question. 5201. Sixth question. 2829. Then seventh question. 3007. So, remaining work you need to practice in your own children. Will you?